Hello, welcome to our channel for R programming. In this video, we will show how to use log normal distribution in R. So we know log normal distribution is used to model a random variable, actually a positive random variable. If these random variables log function has a standard normal distribution, or with a normal distribution with mean, mu, and standard deviation, sigma. So the density function for the normal, for the log normal distribution is quite similar as the normal distribution. Just replace log x here and add x from the normal distribution. So it becomes a log normal distribution is a density function, but only for the positive value. And the mean and the variance of the log normal distribution look like this. The mean is E mu plus sigma squared divided by 2 in power. Just note this mu is not this mu. So here mu and sigma is the parameter mu and sigma in density function. So we also call this log x, log mu, log sigma, right? So this variance is the variance of the log normal random variable. And this mu sigma square is in this density function. So it's not the same sigma, right? And this curve, these two curves are the density function for the log normal distribution with respect to different mu and sigma in the, this is log mu and log sigma in the density function. In R programming, we usually use dpqr, one of these four alphabets, and plus a distribution's abbreviation. So for the log normal distribution, the four functions dlnorm, plnorm, qlnorm, and rlnorm. So D for the density, P for the cumulative probability, and Q for the quantile, and R for the random number generation. So next we will show examples in R Studio using these four functions. So first we will use dlnorm function to calculate the density of specific value from log normal distribution. So the default parameter is mean log and SD log is 0 and 1. So this is the mu and sigma in the log normal density function, not the mean and the standard deviation of a log normal variable. This is in the log of this log normal distribution variables, mean and standard deviation. So this is for the density functions parameter. So usually dlnorm, if we do not add anything except this variable, then it will accept 0 for the mean log and 1 for the SD log. So here we create a vector of positive number first between 1 and 10. Then you can just use dnorm to calculate the density of this vector. You can plot the value and its density value. So it can look like this, from 1 to 10 and the density value. You can also use different mean log and SD log parameter. So mu 5, SD 2, sigma 2. So it's like this for the density. So next function is plnorm, is used to calculate the cumulative probability for a positive random number. So we also create vector of x with positive number between 1 and 10. Then you can just use pnorm to calculate the cumulative probability to each random variable's value with mean log and SD log 0 and 1 respectively. So this is the cumulative probability is an increasing function. A random variable from 1 to 10, for example, here 0.9, and you find the random variable about 3.5. So which means about 90% of values in this log normal distribution has the value less than or equal to 3, right? And similarly, can plot another log normal distribution's cumulative probability with mean log of 5 and SD log 2. And this is a straight line. Sorry. Yes, this is a straight line. And qnorm is the opposite. Is the opposite operation of pnorm, which will calculate the quantile value. Quantile value is another name for the random variable. So which will calculate the value of a log normal variable from the given cumulative probability. So we just create a vector again between 0 and 1 for the cumulative probability and can use qnorm to calculate the quantile value from these cumulative probabilities. Then we plot with the x-axis is the probability and y-axis is the random variable. This curve is for cumulative probability between 0 and 1. This is for the random variable calculated. So again, we find 0.9 here and can find random variable about 3.5. So which means about 90% of the values from this log normal distribution, the value less than or equal to 3.5, between 0 and 3.5. I can also plot another quantile value from different log normal distribution with mean log 5 and SD log 2. So like this. So log normal distributions variable change very much if you change parameter just a little because the parameter is closed to the log function. So which means this value will be the power function of E, right? So it's changed quite a little, quite a big if you just change from mean log to 0 to 1, 0 here 0 to 5, and SD log from 1 to 2 can change a lot for the random variable's value. And the last function we will show is rnorm, is to generate random number from a given log normal distribution. So for example, we set n equals 18. We will generate 18 such random numbers from a standard log normal distribution. So r log norm. So this 18 number from a log normal distribution with SD with mean log 0 and SD log 1. And you can also generate from a different log normal distribution with mean log 5 and SD log 2. You can see that the scale of the number changed quite a lot. Not about several hundred, but the first vector of the random variable is around 1, right? Here is several hundred scale. So difference change very quickly if you just change from 0 to 5 here and 1 to 2 here. And lastly, we will show we create 10,000 random numbers from a log normal distribution to generate a vector x from a standard log normal distribution with 10,000 random number. Next, we calculate the mean value of this vector, about 1.66. Next, if we look at the mean and standard deviation of a log normal distribution. So we just look at the mean for the standard log normal distribution. Mu here is 0 and sigma is 1. So the mean value of a log normal distribution, the square root of E parameter. So we calculate again square root of this E, 2.718 1.64, so it's very close to the random number we have generated. It's quite consistent. Thanks for watching.